Welcome back to season two of Messengers. There are some people in this world who have an innate desire to share their wisdom so that the collective can be assisted in its journey towards self-realization. In the last season, we spoke to Annelie Nell about the art of being human. And in this season, we have Jason Hairston, who will speak to us about the importance of self-mastery.
In 2009, I had a truck job. So at this point in my life, I was meditating, I was reading certain books, and I was starting to get more sensitive to energy and starting to feel things outside of the five senses. So one night when I was driving the truck, I literally got a message, like a telepathic message that said, you need to quit this job. And I'm thinking to myself, how am I gonna pay my bills, my car note? This is crazy, quit my job. I'm literally talking to whatever, wherever that message came from. That doesn't make sense. So the next week, I'm driving, I fall asleep on the road, I crash into a police officer that's attending another accident. I crash, blood everywhere, I lost my two front teeth, cut under my chin, under my lip. My ribs were bruised. I get out the car, it's like a movie set. I couldn't believe it happened. I'm walking towards the police car that I hit. It's smashed up in a small square and it's on fire. So as I walk towards the car, the other cops that were attending the other accident grabbed me and said, that's him. They threw me in the back of the cop car. One of the cops about to punch me in the face. He had his fist raised like this. And in that moment, I went into the nothingness and I was just looking at him like this. I just surrendered to the entire moment. And he went like this. And when I went into that energy, he just stopped. He slammed the door. Took me off in the ambulance. They had me handcuffed to the bed in the hospital. Said, you know you're under arrest. I just sat there, didn't say anything. I knew that I had to stay deep in the present moment to get through the situation, to not escalate it. So I just stayed there. You know, so they put me in the machine to see if I had any internal injuries. I saw the lieutenant standing there watching me as they put me in the machine. And I came out, he was watching me. Went back to the bed. Another cop came, unhandcuffed me, and walked out.